Was there indeed a man that made Kimi Räikkönen look like a choir boy? Yes, sir. His name was James Hunt. He was the 1976 Formula One world champion, and he was a character like none before, and there probably never will be again. This is 10 classic James Hunt moments.
And suddenly there was big panic. A car crashed. Practice was stopped. I saw this McLaren parked on the right side of the long straight, and I said, there's not the tires on, the wheels on, there are no marks, there's nothing what happened. And I got out of the car, and James was sitting in his car sleeping. I said, are you nuts, you idiot? Oh, Nicky, I'm so tired, I can't drive anymore. So this was a typical James testing day after a long night in Vienna.
Number 10, having to race with half his boots cut off.
Got any toes in your shoes?
Well, that's a peculiarity for me because I'm afraid so I've got big feet. And it's not that they're not so big they can't make shoes big enough for me. They're only size 10 or 10 and a half, but there's not very much space in the footwell of the car where my feet go because they have to make the car as low as possible, you see, at the front for aerodynamic reasons to make the car go through the air quicker.
Number 9, being absolutely brutal in the commentary box.
Well, it's a sad thing, Miami. With the greatest respect, Rabac is not a world-class driver. And he's in an infinitely superior car to Carlos Reutemann, which just makes a mockery of Grand Prix racing. And I'm afraid it's the current rules and all the arguments in that having argued for 6 months or more over the rules and practically broken the sport, they then come up with a set of rules which is a load of complete rubbish.
Number 8. Bumming a smoke. From the guy interviewing him in the post-race interview.
James, how much does this victory mean to you?
9 points, $20,000 and a lot of happiness.
How much of a strain was it having to drive after that false start?
Well, it was
nerve-wracking.
No, very relaxing, except that I was naturally worried about the handling of my car. And the first quarter of the race, it wasn't good, and then it seemed to improve as things went on.
How remarkable. Yeah.
Can you give me a cigarette? Can I grab that cigarette off you? Thanks.
What sort of achievement was it on the part of the mechanics to get the car fixed in that very short
space? Absolutely fantastic. I mean, they really did a good job. They had to just throw it on. They had to put both sides of the front suspension had to be renewed, and they had to check the hold of the back, and it was incredible that they got it done.
Taking the mickey when being interviewed by the super serious press from the 1970s.
Well now, James, they've changed the regulations concerning the air boxes and the wings, and yet you're still extremely fast. How do you do it?
Big balls.
Forget it.
Can't they print that?
Yeah, do it again. Just keep going. He's
wrong. No. He's buggering about. We
but it's true. I told the UPI man that, and he thought I was taking the piss.
So did we.
What are your tactics going to be tomorrow?
Cheat at the start.
Number 6, even more savage commentary. Take note, Crofty.
And Charrier really is completely out of order. I mean, he really shouldn't be allowed to drive in Grand Prix racing. He is... he's got a mental age of 10 in the first place, and that was absolutely disgraceful for a driver of his experience. And I would think that the authorities have really got to look at driving like that and do something about it, because he should certainly have a short suspension for that, and for being himself, he should have a permanent suspension.
It's all a terrible mess. Oh dear, the camera went so terrible then. Why couldn't we see the whole thing? Well, unfortunately, the importance of all that was missed by shoddy camera work and bad direction.
Number 5. Inadvertently giving a young Martin Brundle his first commentating break.
There was one occasion when the Belgian Grand Prix 1 year, when James didn't turn up at all. He didn't, not to be seen. 5 minutes before the race, 5 minutes into the race, 25 minutes into the race, for the whole of the race. And I did it alone, and we were getting anybody who'd retired from the race to come into the box and talk to me about it. And that was where Martin Brundle did his first ever commentary or talk on the radio, and that's where we started to discover how good he was. But James never turned up, and he apologised afterwards. He said, I'm terribly sorry I wasn't there, I was in bed with a stomach complaint. And I thought, it's the first time I've ever heard it called that. But I wouldn't be saying these hard things about James if we hadn't actually rubbed the rough edges off each other and got to know each other and got to like each other in the end. And he was a very special chap.
Number four, a fiercely competitive man with a fiery temper, almost beating up a race marshal. Number three, winning a race with a broken gear knob that was slicing his hand to shreds.
Glove off, and what happened was that the gear shift had broken. All he had to change gear was the sort of threaded stub of the gear lever, which is a bit like a sort of blunt knife.
He changed gear by putting the broken end of the gear shift into his hand, and that's how he'd driven the race.
Number two. Yes, he did it. Actually punching a race marshal. Muhammad Ali would be proud. And number one, the greatest classic James Hunt moment, winning the 1976 Formula One World Championship.
When he won the championship by half a point in front of me, I said to him, I'm more happy that you are the world champion than any of the other guys.
And there, James Hunt. James Hunt finishing third and almost catching Patrick Depailler. And James Hunt is the world champion.
And there you have it. 10 James Hunt moments where sometimes he made the legend Kimi Raikkonen look like an absolute choir boy. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit up that sub button, hit up that like button, and share the videos. Also, if you've got some time on your hands, go and check out the movie Rush. It's about the 1976 season, Hunt versus Lauda, and it's pretty freaking awesome. Any race fan would enjoy it. And that's it, that's the end of our video. Thank you for watching, thanks for your time, God bless, and remember, you are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of God, and He has a plan for your life. God bless.